I am making tacos al pastor today. Actually, it's going to be tomorrow because I'm going to marinate it. You need a 3-pound boneless shoulder blade or butt roast. And it's real hard to find pork right now in California because of their restrictions on how they take care of the animals and stuff like that. You can look it up. They need like 24 square feet per hog or something. Anyhow, I've been getting these on Amazon. These are 2 pounds each, but the bone is still in these. So by the time you get the bone out and cut some of that fat off, I bought 2 of them so that I'll get at least 3 pounds. Otherwise, it won't. So anyhow, I'm thawing these out. They were frozen. You don't want them all the way thawed. You want them partially frozen to be able to cut them thin. And I'll show you that in a little bit. They're actually getting pretty close right now. Again, I'm making tacos al pastor. The recipe is on wildforkfoods.com. You have to look for it a little bit though. It calls for 3 pounds of pork shoulder butt roast, boneless, or like I've got with the bone and cut the bone out. 3 guajillo chilies, and I've got those in a bag. I'm going to do, these are kind of small. I'm going to do extra. I always do everything a little extra. Here's 3, and I'm going to do these little pieces and this skinny one. So, 3 guajillo chilies, 5 cloves of garlic. I've got organic garlic there. 1 teaspoon of oregano. I'll tell you all these amounts later again. 1/2 a teaspoon of cumin. Some ground black pepper. Some salt. 1 tablespoon of añado. I don't know if I'm saying that right. Añado. Achiote powder. Achiote. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it. Apologize if I'm not saying it right. But it's fantastic. You can get this on Amazon or from a lot of your grocery stores have it now. Achiote powder, 1 tablespoon, 1 cup of pineapple chunks. You're going to blend this so it doesn't matter. I didn't have chunks. I've got slices. And I think that'll be a cup. If not, I'm going to have to open another can. 1 pepper from a can of chipotle in adobo sauce. You can use any brand. So you're going to use, and these are real hot. So if you like hot, fine. If you don't, maybe use less. But this is just a marinade that's going on it. And I think it makes it. So try it the first time with it. 1 pepper from the can. And 1 tablespoon of the sauce that the pepper is in also. And I think I put extra last time. 1/4 cup of white vinegar. 1/2 a cup of orange juice. I've got some fresh oranges, so I'm going to squeeze what I can from, probably 1 orange will be enough. And 1 tiny onion. That's all for your marinade. And 1 teaspoon of light oil, such as avocado or some type of light olive oil, just to make the marinade kind of adhere together so it sticks to the meat. So, we're going to do that first, and then later I'll tell you what goes on it and how you finish these. But we're going to do the meat today and marinate it, and then I'll continue from there. But right now, I'm going to open these up with scissors, take the seeds out, take any stems out, put them into that bowl over there, and get some hot water and put over them so that we can rehydrate them. See, they're like leather right now. Okay, I used my scissors, my kitchen scissors, and just went up one side of all of these so that I could open them up and get all those seeds out. And there was only 1 that had a stem, and I cut that stem off with the scissors also. So I'm going to de-seed these right now. I'll show you that. And most of the seeds, if you just open it and go like that, come out. On this one, they stuck a little bit. Just take your finger and scrape them off. And then put them in a bowl. And just so these rehydrate better, I'm going to take scissors and cut them in half right here, like that. And that way it'll open them up more for that water to get in there. And I'm going to cover them with hot water. I'm just going to use hot tap water, I think. You can use boiling if you want to, but it doesn't matter. That's what they look like right now. I decide I am going to do boiling water. I think it would rehydrate them better. So get a big thing of boiling water going, enough to cover them. I've got a tea kettle going. For the rest of the recipe, you're going to need another can of pineapple, a large can, or fresh pineapple. You need pineapple rings, or what they call slices, like that. I'm going to get a big can of that for later, for serving, because you're going to grill those later. You want jalapeno rings or pickled jalapeno rings, fresh cilantro, salsa verde, which is green salsa, any brand, whatever you like, some fresh limes if you have them to garnish and squeeze over them when they're done. If you don't, that's fine. Red onion or regular onion. And the recipe calls for 12 to 16 corn tortillas. I just get a small package out, so. And you need some wood chips for your grill. This is a grilling recipe. You could probably broil it. I don't know if it would be as good. I've never tried it. But I usually use whatever wood I have, mesquite, apple, whatever. I think right now I might have hickory. So you want some of that to help smoke the meat while it's cooking. And you want to soak the wood for several hours. This is not going to be all done in one day, though. You need to marinate this. How long does it say? At least 6 hours. Last time I did it 2 days, and it was fantastic. So the longer you can wait, probably the better. And I think that's about it. So I'm going to get the hot water over this when it's ready and let that sit. Okay. What you want to do is, while it's still partially frozen, and this is getting close to being thawed out, so I'm going to try to hurry up and do this. You want to cut that big slab of fat off and throw it out, which I already did on this one. See, I took all that off. And if you got boneless, you're good. You can just start thinly slicing them. But there's a big bone in this. I think you can see it right here. So I'm going to try to cut around that. I'm going to start at this end, cut until I run into that, and then try to get rid of it. But yeah, I've got bones in both of these, so I got to deal with that. But and then you want to cut them thinly. I'll show you when I do it. I have to keep washing my hands in between so I won't contaminate my iPod. Okay, what I did after I cut the fat off, then I tried to cut it in half pretty even. It's too thin to cut this way, you know, like right here. So I cut it in half, turned it this way, and then sliced it this way. So as you can see that this is an example of it. I had it like that. Okay. So once you cut the fat off, cut it in half, and then turn it up like that and cut your slices. But this is the first one. And yes, there's fat through it, but that's what really makes it. If you grill it good and not raw, it's going to taste really good. Here's the bone. Now, last time I did this, I had a bone in there, but that was, it took up half the meat. I mean, it was huge, so I don't know what to tell you. Sometimes they're big, sometimes they're smaller, but, and when I got done, I found a piece hooked to one of these, so kind of feel that after it thaws. It's still frozen right now, and see if you find any more bones in it, so. I'm going to throw that away. I know it might make good broth, but I'm not going to do that. So I'm going to do this other one. Okay, I've got all the meat in this large bowl. And the meat cooks down quite a bit. Alright, in the meantime, I just poured the hot water over these. I will let them stand for a while. It says on the recipe 20 to 30 minutes. You want them to be, you'll feel the difference. They'll feel thicker and softer and more pliable. So in the meantime, I'm going to measure everything else out though. Okay, I drained that, and that one can was a cup, so that's all you need for the marinade. One cup of pineapple chunks. Like I said, I had sliced. I just cut them up. They're going to get blended, so it doesn't matter. One teaspoon oregano. I have the leaf kind. I'm going to crunch this up, and it should equal the one teaspoon. I'm going to crumble it over that. Okay, next, a half a teaspoon cumin. Put that aside. A shake of ground black pepper. So, get my pepper. I'll do a couple shakes. There. Okay. Okay, 1.5 teaspoons of salt. I use real salt. It's not the kind like you get in the grocery store. I think they may carry that at the store now, though. And there's a half a teaspoon. Okay, let's see. Got the salt, got the pepper, a tablespoon of the achiote annatto. I'm not sure if I'm saying it right, but I have one whole tablespoon. And I'm doing a nice big rounded one. This is what gives it a lot of the color and the flavor. Fantastic. Okay, we got the achiote. We got the pineapple. Let's see, what else do we need? I have to do 5 cloves of garlic. And remember, you're going to blend this, so you don't have to cut them up. Just get the skins off of them. So there you go. That one at the end was like one that was split into two. So just throw those in with the rest of the stuff. So, okay. The chilies I got to wait for. A teaspoon of oil. I'm going to add that when I put it in the blender. 5 cloves of garlic. 1 teaspoon of oregano. Half teaspoon cumin. Shake of black pepper. 1.5 teaspoons salt. Tablespoon of achiote, a cup of pineapple chunks, 1 pepper from the can of chili chipotle adobo. So I got to get a pepper out, and I may put 2. I think I did 2 last time. I like it hot. And a tablespoon of the sauce. And I wanted to say, you can always taste this before you put it on the meat. And if it's not hot enough to your liking, add more of you know. I think last time I added more of the peppers, the chipotle, and more of the sauce too. So, but just go according to what you like. But taste it before you put it on the meat. Otherwise, you're going to be eating the raw pork, and that's not good. Let's see. So I need 1 pepper and a tablespoon of the sauce. See, this is 1. I'm going to put 2. And this has got real thick sauce. I'm going to have to get down in there to get that sauce out. I'm going to cut these up just to get it to blend easier once it's in there. Probably don't have to, though. Okay, next, 1/4 cup of white vinegar, any brand of vinegar. I put it in before I recorded it. I forgot to take it. And next, I need to get an onion, small onion, and 1/2 cup orange juice. Okay, peel the onion. And then quarter it so it's easier for the blender. 1 small onion. And now 1/2 cup of orange juice. Okay, I squeeze 1 huge orange. Anyhow, I used part of the pineapple juice that was left to make the full 1/2 cup. And I put that in this. My camera died for a minute. I think it was too full. I had to take the videos off of it. I just got an iPod. So, I think that's everything. Let's see what these are doing. I'll let these go a little bit longer. Just a little bit, but see how pliable they're getting? Getting really nice. So I'm going to take a break and let these go for maybe 10, 15 more minutes. And I forgot to say that you need 1 teaspoon of oil. It says 1 teaspoon or more. I think I just used 1 teaspoon on it. To get it to adhere to the meat. And you want something that can handle high heat from the grill. I'm using avocado oil. So I'm going to put a teaspoon of that in it. So I stirred all this really well and to get all the powders and stuff mixed. And when you put that into a Ninja blender or other blender, get a rubber spatula to make sure you're getting all the stuff off the bottom of the bowl and the sides. Okay, I have my Ninja set up over here. You can use any blender that will do this, so don't worry about having a certain kind. I'm going to try to do this and not be too messy. And so far my camera's working this time. Well, I hate that when they want to do updates right when you're in the middle of something. Evidently, I don't have enough storage space on this thing left either. So I had to get rid of some stuff. And now I'm good. At least for the time being, anyhow. And I think that's it. I'm going to save this juice, this water, in case I need to thin it out more yet. So I'm going to stop this for a second and put this in. I can't do it with one hand. And I still got the camera going here. That's what it looks like in there. I will see what it looks like when I get done. It may need more. I'm getting stuff all over the place. It may need more juice. And make sure you get all that stuff out of the bowl, because mine had a lot sticking on the bottom. Okay. Just pulse it a little bit at first if you have a Ninja like this one. If you don't, go for it. If you have a regular blender, go for it. I just like to get it chopped up a little bit and then go. Looking pretty good. I'll go one more time. Okay. And if you have your Ninja, be careful with your motor, because if you drop that, you're all done. You won't be able to use it again. And be careful with this stuff, because I think that can stain clothing and stuff. So I'm going to get this out. Stuff out there. Put that over there. And that's what it looks like. Nice and thick. And that will stick to the meat nicely, it looks like. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and pour that over the meat. And with my hands, I'm going to work it into the meat. Let me get this out of there. When I get done, I'm going to scrape some of this stuff, try to get all of that. Yeah, it looks like it did pretty good. Okay. I'm going to go over to the table where the meat is. Make everybody dizzy. And there's the meat. And I'm going to pour this over it. I just love this stuff. And I know for those that are going to say, oh, that's not traditional, al pastor usually is cooked on a vertical spit like rotisserie. I know that. But this recipe is done differently on the grill, and it makes it easier for anybody that wants to do it. You don't have to have any special thing except a grill. I'm going to scrape the rest of that into this. I'll be right back. Like I said, it can be done on a grill. If you don't have a grill, use like a hibachi or, you know, charcoal. Just don't do it too hot. You want to do it kind of medium. Or you could probably broil it in the house if you have a broiler or an indoor grill. Do it however you have to do it. But I'm going to take my hands and get in here and move all this around. You want to get the meat coated really good. If you don't want to do it with your hands, get a spatula or something, or get somebody else to do it for you. I'm not squeamish about this stuff. It's like playing in dirt when you're a kid. Keep flipping the stuff over, get it all covered good. Part of it's still frozen. And I'm gonna have to check this too. Again, when you're eating it or putting it on the grill, whatever, you know, be careful of bones if you had the kind with the bone in it, because you may have cut part of the bone and got some of it in it. Try to get boneless if you can. And even then, lately it seems like everything I'm getting that's got ground meat, like sausage, I've had bones show up in that. So be careful anytime you're eating something that's had bones in it that could be still in there. You know, sausage, even hamburger, that kind of stuff. Be careful. Unless you want to break a tooth. Okay, I'm done. I'm going to scrape my hand on the side. Okay, I'm going to cover this with a shower cap that I use just for the kitchen. If you never thought of that, it's a great idea. Oh, I'm getting it all over now. I'm going to refrigerate it for at least, you want to do it at least 6 hours. I'm going to do it a day or two, and I'll show you the rest when I do it. And I'm going to get this put away. And before you put that in your refrigerator, make sure there's no juices or anything running down the sides of your bowl, you know, that might have that pork in it and might contaminate something else in the fridge. Wipe it the outside off with a soapy dishcloth or something and get that cleaned up. You don't want to contaminate other foods. So there it is. It's all, see how nice these shower caps fit over stuff? Now for the cleanup of the mess. I will see you later. For the rest of your recipe, whenever you're ready, again, this is on Wild Fork Foods website. I normally buy the pork from them for this, but lately, according to stupid laws in California, that what they're changing all the time, they're not allowing pork to come into the state that isn't some type of humanely raised pork, where they have to have something like 24 square feet per hog. And that's, a lot of places aren't going to have that. So I haven't seen it. I haven't looked the last week or so on Wild Fork Foods, but the last time I tried to buy pork for this, they did not have any available for my area. So I don't know what's happening now, but I'll have to check back. But the recipe's on their website if you look for it. And like I said, normally I buy the pork from them. Get any pork shoulder, butt roast, that's boneless preferably, so you don't have to deal with that cutting around that bone. And if you can't, get it with the bone in it. So any kind of pork shoulder roast. And I got sidetracked again. For serving it, you're going to need some fresh sliced pineapple or one can. I usually use the canned to make, you know, that way you know that it's, sometimes you get fresh pineapples and they aren't ripe or they're overripe or something. I like to get the canned for this because you don't have to worry about it. You're going to grill those. So you want one large can, I think it's like 20 ounces or something, of sliced pineapple. You want fresh cilantro. You want a jar of some type of salsa verde or green salsa. You want fresh limes if you have them. You don't have to if you don't have them. A red onion chopped, or if you don't have red onion, use a sweet onion chopped. And a package of corn tortillas, depending on how many people you're going to serve. It says 12 to 16 on here, but... And then you want wood chips. All right, right now I've got hickory. So that's what you're going to need for the rest of the recipe whenever that is marinated. So I'll show you the rest later. Okay, I got this out and I'm draining it in a colander. There's not much juice coming out though. And I'm doing this right around the time I'm putting the wood on, the wood chips. So you want to let that sit out at room temperature while you're doing the wood chips. And I drain the pineapple. So I'm going to go out and start the grill on high heat with the wood chips. Okay. in my little foil pan. I'll cover it. The foil pan's got holes in it. And it's going to go, you probably can't see this, it's going to go under the grate on the grill. And I'm turning the grill on high heat. Can't see very good, it's getting dark. All three burners are going to get going. And shut the lid. I know you couldn't see it very well, but I put the wood chips in underneath the grate on top of the grill bars, and I've got it on high heat, and I'm going to wait about 10-15 minutes till it starts smoking, and then turn it down to medium and put the meat on. And you're going to grill the meat till it's got chars on it and looks like it's done. There's no set time, so I'll show you that when I get it done. And the pineapple. You're going to just get it so it's got grill marks on it. I'll try to put a headlamp on so you can see it better. You can see it smoking now, so I'm going to turn it down to medium. And go get the meat. I've got everything in a big bowl. I'm going to take it out with some tongs and get her going. Some of this stuff is bigger than others, so it's going to take longer. That's just about it. Just a couple more pieces. Shut this and come back out in a little bit. Meantime, if you're not going to eat for a while, put your oven on like warm or 200 around there. Just, and you can keep the meat and everything warm in the oven. I'm not ready to eat for a while, so I'm going to do that. And I've got my tortillas ready. You want to do whatever tortillas you want, but I'm doing organic corn. These are really good. And I put a little bit of oil in the skillet and fry them a little bit on each side and drain them on a paper towel, and that's how I do those. I'm not going to show you all that, but and you want to have red onion, pickled jalapenos, cilantro, and some salsa verde to put on them. Some of them are sticking, but that's all right. I want chard. Okay. go. Okay, this is what you want them to look like. Depending on your grill, you know, it might take longer than what I'm doing it, so I'm not even gonna, I think mine was like 25 or 30 minutes total, but it may not have been, I don't know. I didn't really keep track. Just go by how it looks. And I took the little skinny pieces off earlier than the later pieces. Like this last one right there, that was really thick. It took longer than the rest. But that's what you want them to look like. You want them to look charred and most of the fat burned off of them. As you can see, that was a huge bowl of meat before, and now it's just in a little 8x8 pan. So it really cooks down a lot, and that's the fat is what really flavors it. And I took the pineapple off about halfway through. You don't want to overcook it. You just want it to look like that. So now I'm going to let it cool for a few minutes, cut it up into little pieces with a knife, and cut those up and throw it all together and mix it up in a big bowl. And that's what you're going to put in your tacos. And I'll show you it later. Okay, when you bring it in, cut the pineapple up in little pieces. As you can see, like this, little tiny pieces, like that. Just chop everything up. Chop the meat up in pieces about like that. I have to eat some. And take your hands or a spoon and mix it all up. Get that pineapple mixed all in there. And you're ready to go. Make your taco shells. Add some red onion, green salsa, cilantro, and pickled jalapenos. In case I don't show it to you, I think I will though. I'm going to put this in the oven, keep it warm, till I'm ready to eat. And I'm covering it with foil. Yeah, it should keep nice in a warm oven or, you know, anywhere between warm and 200 should keep it nice till you're ready to eat. And then you want to do your tortillas. Okay, I cut up, I did chopped red onion. You can use regular onion if you don't have it. I'm doing these old El Paso jalapeno slices that are pickled. I chopped those like that. And I chopped some fresh cilantro. And if you have a lime, you can squeeze some lime over it. I don't happen to have any limes. But that's everything that goes on it. And you just want to make your tortilla however you want it. You can heat your tortillas in the oven or you can fry them in a skillet. And I'll show you the end result when I get to it. Okay, this is the way I do my tortillas. You can do yours however you want. I've got a pan over here since I'm going to put them in the oven for a while I make a few of them. Get a little bit of oil in your skillet, nonstick. I'm heating it up a little bit first though. Let me heat it up. I've got on number 7 on my burner, which is medium heat. And when you're ready and you think it's warm, take your tortilla, rub it around like this. And when you do two at a time, do the same thing. Rub them around in the oil, flip them over, rub them around, and then let them go. See, these are bubbling already. So this skillet's getting nice and warm now. I don't think I have to show you the whole thing, but I'll show you a little bit more on these. Okay, I've got the meat and pineapple on the tortillas. I am going to put some onion, depending on how much you like. Oops, I don't want that big chunk. some jalapeno. Some salsa. A little bit more on the other one. Okay. And some cilantro. Fresh cilantro. Beautiful. And if you want salt and pepper, you can, but I'm not going to. Because the meat and stuff had all that seasoning in it. So that's your tacos al pastor. Enjoy. And you can freeze it. You know, freeze the meat. I usually have it for a couple meals, and then whatever's left, have it for lunch and freeze the rest.